But the female white tiger's name is Abu, and her boyfriend is an African male lion named Cameron. Now, this is a pretty unique relationship. Cats normally wouldn't be friends, but in the case of when they're raised together, then typically they go to can hunting or internet hunting. Can hunting is legal here in the United States, and these cats are put to a very small cage, and they're shot. And that person pays a lot of money to shoot them and take them home stuffed. Also legal here in the United States, and specifically in Florida, is internet hunting. You don't have to leave the privacy of your own home. All you have to do is enter your credit card number, point and click with your mouse. At the same point in time, a rifle will go off shooting the animal. So unfortunately, for all those beautiful white tigers you see in entertainment acts or on display, there are a lot that have had to suffer. There are a lot that end up in those horrible situations. The way that white tigers made their way into the United States, every white tiger you see on display can genetically young.
That is so cool.
So if a white tiger cub's born in the wild, the mother will most likely abandon it or kill it because it has no natural camouflage. It'll give away the sighting of all the other cubs. But this white tiger cub was spotted when it was very young, and it was something rare and unusual. You're fascinated by it. So this white tiger cub was captured and named Mohan.
Awesome.
And they wanted to use Mohan to make more white tigers. So when Mohan was sexually mature, they began breeding him. Well, they bred him to every golden tiger they could, but no white tigers were coming out. They became frustrated. So that's when they got the idea to breed Mohan to his daughter. That's when the whole first litter of white tiger cubs was born. And one of those white tiger cubs was given to the President of the United States as a gift. That white tiger was put in our national zoo. So all of the white tigers in the United States that you see on this display can all be genetically traced back to Mohan because it all stemmed from him. Now this picture right over here, in front of you guys down at the end, is Kenny. Kenny is not our white tiger and he's never lived here. He lived in another sanctuary in Arkansas. He is no longer with us, but if you go home and you Google white tigers, Kenny's face will show up everywhere. He is the poster child for what most white tigers come out looking like. In fact, there's a lot of are stillborn because of their genetic disability at 4:45 or 5 o'clock. So the cats know that when feeding time comes around. But if you guys will follow me down this way, I'll introduce you to some more deformities, but he also didn't have a top palate to his mouth. So his whole life he had to eat a liquid diet. So I encourage you guys to educate everybody about white tigers because unfortunately there are a lot of us out there who think there's such a species as the endangered royal white Bengal tiger. And that's because that's what we've all been fed as a way to ignore the fact that they're all inbred. They shouldn't exist. Now, her handsome boyfriend, Cameron.
Here she comes.
Now, despite how hard a male lion's life is in the wild, they have it pretty easy when it comes to feeding time. The females are the ones that do all the honey, and the males are the ones that eat first. So luckily that didn't carry over into our species. But Zabu here knows her place at feeding time. She knows that Cameron eats first. When he's done, she gets her turn. Now, we refer to Cameron as the Brad Pitt of all lions because he has such a gorgeous mane. Was to stand up, you'd see it extends all the way down his belly and halfway down his back. The fuller, the darker the mane, the better the genetics of the male lion.
What I'm doing?
So,
that's pretty ugly. I'm still fine. I take pictures from it,
too. Females,
I can take pictures here. I'll take a couple pictures.
Although, they wouldn't be very pleased to find out that this boy right here received a vasectomy. Special privilege case, because unfortunately, guys, the neutering is the easiest procedure. It's the less invasive, so the males are always the ones fixed. But if we had fixed him, he would have lost his gorgeous mane that's directly linked to his testosterone. So he lucked out and received a vasectomy. Cameron over here loves his pine trees, so he gets the biggest collection of them. He'll